Gananjana Shalakaya Chaksurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Vanchakottarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasati Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. All right, so we're hearing about the life of Ajamila, who was born a Brahmana, but had become very fallen, degraded.
我们听到的是阿迦弥勒的生平，他出生在一个婆罗门的家庭之中，但是后来变得非常堕落。So
88 years of his life had passed. He had 10 sons, and the youngest son was called Narayan.
80年的这个生活过去了，他有10个儿子，最小的那个儿子的名字叫Narayan.
And Ajamila was very much attached to this child, and he would always take care and enjoy the child's activities.
这个阿迦弥勒非常依附他这个小孩子，他总是非常享受这个小孩子，非常喜欢他的这些各种各样的活动.
Whenever Ajamila would eat, he would call Narayan, "Come and eat with me." And whenever he would drink, he would tell Narayan, "Come and drink with me."
每当阿迦弥勒要吃什么东西的时候，他就说：“Narayana，请过来跟我一起吃。”他要喝什么东西的时候，他说：“Narayana，请过来和我一起喝。”So
Ajamila could understand that he was near to death; that death was coming very close to him.
阿迦弥勒也能理解到，他现在可能马上就要死了，濒临死亡。
So when it came time for him to die, to leave the body, he began to think about his son, Narayan.
当他差不多快要死的时候，他就开始想他的儿子Narayan.
So Ajamila was, he was also born in a Brahmana family. His father was a Brahmana. So as a child, he used to worship the Narayan Shila.
Narayana 是出生在一个婆罗门的家庭，他父亲也是一位婆罗门 Brahmana. 当他还是小的时候，他就崇拜这个 Narayana Shila.
The Brahmanas usually they have that duty, they have the right. Those who are Brahmanas, that they will worship the Shalagram Shila, and the Shalagram Shila is a form of Narayan.
婆罗门有这个职责去崇拜 Narayana的这个Shalagram Shila，所以这个阿迦弥勒也崇拜了这个Shalagram Shila，这个Shalagram Shila是Narayana的一个形象。So
when he would chant, when he would call for his son by the name Narayan, he would also think of the Shila which he used to worship when he was a young man.
当他在呼唤这个Narayana的名字的时候，他也想起了他年轻的时候崇拜的这个Narayana Shila的这个形象。So
because Ajamila was always chanting his son's name Narayan, he became, he came to the platform of bhakti, doing devotion, but he didn't know it.
当Narayana唱诵这哦不，当阿迦弥勒唱诵Narayana这个名字的时候。 他实际上在从事奉献服务，但是他并不知道自己是在从事奉献服务。So
at the time of death, he was chanting for his son.
在他名字濒临死亡的时候，他就开始唱诵他儿子的名字。
But that his son's name was the same as the holy name of the Lord, Narayan.
但是他儿子的名字就是和主的圣名是一样的 ，Narayan.
So Ajmila remembered the Lord at the time of death.
因此，阿加米拉在死亡的时候记起了主的名字。
So then, Ajamila saw these three persons who were really frightening. Their faces were all twisted, and their hair was standing erect on their bodies.
然后阿加米勒就看到三个非常可怕的身形，外貌非常令人恐惧的这个人就出现在他面前。
And they had ropes in their hand. They'd come to take Ajmila to Yamaraj.
而且他们手上还带着绳子，他们想把这个阿加米勒带到 Yamaraj 的那里去。
So Ajmila was very afraid, and he knew that his son Narayan was playing just nearby. So he began to call his name loudly.
因此，阿加米勒当时非常的害怕。而他的儿子就在旁边在玩耍，所以他就大声地呼唤他儿子的名字。
And with tears in his eyes, he was calling Narayan, Narayan, Narayan.
他的眼泪都流出来了，他就呼唤了他儿子的名字 Narayan, Narayan, Narayan.
So when somebody does sinful activities, they do the sinful activities with their body, with their mind, and with words also.
当人做用身体、心意和言语去从事罪恶活动的时候
，So that's why three servants of Yamaraj came to take Ajmil to Yamaraj's place.
因为他用这三个方面从事了罪恶活动，所以 Yamaraj 派了这三个人来逮这个阿加米勒。
But because Ajmila was calling for his son, he chanted this.Holy name of the Lord.
但由于阿加米勒呼唤了他儿子的名字，这个名字又是主的名字。
Four syllables, Narayana, Narayana, four syllables.
有四个音节 ，Narayana.
So the Vishnu Duras also came there because they heard the name of their master.
因此，维什努都塔那个时候也来了，因为他们听见有人在呼唤他们主人的名字。
But he never meant to chant the holy name of the Lord. He just meant to call his son.
但这个阿加米勒不是有意想要去呼唤主的名字，他只是想去喊他儿子的名字而已。
So the order carriers of Vishnu, the Vishnu Dutas, they came there.When they heard the name of their master, they all came there.
当维什努都塔听到有人呼唤他们主人的名字的时候，维什努都塔就来到了那里。
Actually, Ajmil had chanted the holy name without offense, because he was in so much anxiety when he chanted, there was no offense.
事实上，阿加米勒在唱诵主的名字的时候是没有冒犯的。因为他唱诵的时候是非常急切渴望、非常渴望的想要去唱诵的。
So the Vishnu Dutas, they didn't consider why he was chanting. They just heard that he's chanting, so they came.
这些维什努都塔没有考虑阿加米勒是为什么唱诵主的名字，他只是认为这个人在唱诵主的名字，所以就来了。
So the Vishnu Duras came and they want to protect Ajmil because they heard him chanting the name of the Supreme Lord.
Vishnu Duta 来了就想来保护阿加米勒，因为他听到了阿加米勒唱诵至尊主的名字。
Ajmil actually, he didn't glorify the Lord. He wasn't thinking about the Lord or about the Lord's qualities. The only thing he did was chant the holy name.
事实上，阿加米勒没有去荣耀主，他只是在唱诵主的圣名。
But because he chanted the holy name, He got rid of all of his sinful reactions.
但是由于他唱诵主的圣名，他就摆脱了所有的罪恶报应。
And the Vishnu Duras, they heard him chanting, so they immediately came there.
Vishnu Duta 也听到了他唱诵，所以他们立刻就来到了那里。
Ajimiyo chanted that name because it was so attached to his son.
Ajimila 唱诵那个名字，因为他太依附他的儿子了。
But also because in his past he'd done some devotional service, so when he chanted the holy name, he got a lot of benefit. He chanted the holy name in devotion without offense.
因为他以前也从事过一些奉献服务，因此他在唱诵主的圣名的时候，得到了也是怀着奉爱在唱诵。
So the Yamaduras, they were trying to take Ajimil's soul out of his body, out of the heart of Ajimil. They were trying to rip his soul out.
这些亚玛都塔，他们想把阿加米勒的灵魂从他的心里面给拽出来。
They said, this man is the husband of the prostitute. We have to take him to Lord Yamaraj for punishment.
他们说这个阿加米勒他是妓女的丈夫，我们得把他带到 Yamaraj 那里去。
But the Vishnu Duras appeared there, they wouldn't let them do it.
但是 Vishnu Duta 当时显现了，他们不允许这些 Yamaduta 做这些事情。
Anybody who surrendered to the lotus feet of Lord Vishnu is always protected by Lord Vishnu's servants, the Vishnu Duras.
任何向至尊主臣服的人都被至尊主的这些仆人，这些维什努都他们所保护。
So because Ajimila chanted the holy name of the Lord Narayan, the Vishnu Duras, they came and they told the Yamaduras not to touch him, leave him alone.
因为阿加米勒唱诵了至尊主的名字，所以维什努都塔告诉亚玛都塔，请你们停止，让他不要动他。
And they spoke very powerfully, and they told the Yamadutas that if you touch him, we will punish you.
而且这个维什努都塔说话的时候非常强而有力。他们说，如果你们再动这个阿加米勒的话，我们会惩罚你们。
Now the Yamadutas they have.The power, the right to take away any sinful people to Yamaraj.
Yamaduta, 事实上，他们是有权利带走那些罪恶的人到 Yamaraj 那里去的。
But the Vishnu Duras, they can punish anybody, even Yamaraj, if he does something wrong to a devotee.
而 Vishnu Duta 的权力更大，他甚至有权利去惩罚。Yamaraj, 如果 Yamaraj 做了什么不对的事情对于奉献者的话。
So you have to deal very carefully with devotees. You never want to do any wrong to a devotee.
因此我们应该非常小心对待奉献者，不要对奉献者做出任何很错误的事情。
Even Yamaraj is one of the Mahajans, but if he does something wrong, if he offends a Vaishnava, then he can get problems.
即便是 Yamaraj, 他是十二位伟大的权威之一，即便是 Yamaraj 这样伟大的奉献者，如果他对奉献者做了冒犯的话，他也会有麻烦。
So one time, Yamaraj punished a sage that he'd done something wrong when he was a child. He was sticking blades of grass into insects. So when he grew up, he was to get punished. He was to be killed by sticking a spear into him.
当Yamaraj 之前冒犯过一个圣人，然后那还是他小的时候。当他长大之后，他就被这个圣人所诅咒有惩罚。
Yeah. Well, that makes it very simple. So Prabhupada warned also devotees, he said, the JBC, you have to be very careful in dealing with the devotees. He said, you may get cursed, because Yamaraj got cursed to become a Sudra.
因此圣帕帕德对GBC的这些管理委员会们也非常强烈地警告他们，你们要非常小心地处理于奉献者的关系。你们看这个Yamaraj，他也被一个圣人所诅咒，成为了一个Sudra。
So be very careful not to harm a devotee. If you do wrong to the devotee, you'll get big problems.
因此我们应该非常小心，不要对奉献者有什么伤害。如果对他们有伤害的话，会有很大的麻烦。
So Prabhupada also makes the point that most people, they don't know where is the soul, but it's very clear from the Srimad Bhagavatam that the soul is in the heart of all living entities.
圣帕帕德在这里也讲述了一个非常重要的一点，就是人们并不知道灵魂在什么地方。实际上在这里描述得很清楚，灵魂就在人们的心中。
And it's not just only one soul, but there's the individual soul and also the super soul.
而且不仅仅只是一个灵魂，除了个体灵魂之外，还有超灵在里面。
So they're like two birds in the tree.
就像一棵树上的两只鸟一样。
Okay, so then we learn about how the body is like a machine, and the driver of the machine is the soul.
我们知道这个身体，我们也学到，之前也学到，这个身体像一个机器，而这个机器的驾驶者就是这个灵魂。
And the body is a creation of Maya. According to our activities, we get a particular type of body.
而这个躯体就是玛雅的创造物，根据不同的这个活动，我们得到不同的躯体。
So the next body we take is according to the activities we do and the consciousness we have in this life.
我们得到的下一个躯体依据于我们现在所从事的这个活动。
And at the time of death, the soul and the super soul, they both enter into the next body.
离开躯体的那个时候，我们的灵魂和超灵会一起进入到下一个躯体。So
when we go from one body to the other, sometimes the order carriers, the servants of Yamaraj, they will come and they will put the soul into a kind of hellish life. In order, the purpose of putting them into hell is to get them prepared for the next body.
当我们在离开躯体的时候，有时候 Yamaraj 的这些随从 Yamadu 他们会来，他会根据我们的这个活动，会有可能会把我们带到这个地狱里面去。而我们去地狱情况是为了下一次的这个人生，下一次的生命做准备。So
the servants of Yamaraj, they were told to stop, and when they were told to stop. Then they asked the Yamadutas, the Vishnu Dutas, the Yamadutas asked the Vishnu Dutas, who are you? What right have you got to stop us?
在这些Yamaduta被要求停止的时候, Yamaduta就开始问Vishnu Duta, 你们是谁? 你们有什么权利来阻止我们?
Yamaraj is the son of the sun god, and the sun god is very powerful in the universe.
Yamaraj is the sun god's son, and the sun god is
very powerful. The sun is the king of all planets within the universe. It's said like that in the Brahma Samhita.
In the Brahma Samhita, it says that the sun god is the king of all planets.
Yakchakshiresha savita sakala grahanam raja samasta suramurti rashesha teja yashyagnaya brahmati sambarata kala chakro govindamadipursham tamaham bhajami. In the Brahma Samhita, it describes that the sun is like the eye of the Lord, and it, as it moves around the universe, it's rotating the wheel of time.
在这个 Brahma Samhita 里面说，太阳就像至尊主的眼睛，它像时间之轮一样，在这个宇宙中行走。
So the Lord Yamaraj, he's the son of the sun god. So these Yamaduras were acting on the authority of Yamaraj.
Yamaraj 是太阳神之子，而这些 Yamaduta 他们是完全根据 Yamaraj 的指令在行动。
Actually, Yamaraj had never told them to go and get Ajamil, but they just assumed that he's a sinful person. We're going to take him to Yamaraj.
事实上，阿加米这个 Yamaraj 并没有直接告诉他们去把这个阿加米勒给带回来，他们只是立即去执行，说哪些是属于罪恶的人，他们就把这些罪恶的人给带回来。
So the Yamaduras, they knew this Ajami was sinful, so they thought he has to go to Yamaraj. We have to take him there. He has to get punished.
Yamaraj 的这些 Yamaduta 们，他们认为这个阿加米勒就是很罪恶的人，认为他是很罪恶的人，所以他就觉得应该把这个阿加米勒带到 Yamaraj 来去。
But the Vishnu Duras came and they said, "Don't touch Ajamil."
但是维什努都塔这个时候来了，说不要碰阿加米勒。
So the Yamaduras were shocked because nobody had ever stopped them before.
这个时候亚玛都塔就感觉到很惊讶。因为从来没有人对他们那样说话。
Yeah, they've been doing their duty in all the different places in the universe, and nobody had ever stopped them before. They were very surprised.
他们以前在宇宙各个地方从事着自己的职责和活动，但是从来没有人阻止过他们，他们感觉到非常的惊讶。
So the Yamadutas asked the Vishnu Dutas, whose servants are you?Where do you come from? And why are you stopping us?
这个亚玛都塔就问维什努都塔，你们是谁的仆人？你们从哪里来？为什么要阻止我们？
Are you some kind of demigod from the heavenly planets?
你们是天堂星球的半世人吗？
Or are you just some kind of lower demigods?
或者你们还你们只是一些准半世人，低于半世人的人。
Or maybe you're the best of devotees.
还是说你们是奉献者中最好的那一位？
We know the best of the devotees, they're very rare. That means they're very rare, but they're perfect. They're perfect in devotional service.
我们知道奉献者中最好的那一位，他们非常的罕有。
Somebody who is perfect in devotional service, they know they're not the body, they know they're a spirit soul. Hardly anybody knows that.
如果有人他们在奉献服务中获得的完美，他们是理解到他们不是这个躯体，他们是灵魂，但是呢，很少有人能觉悟到这一点。
And if somebody understands that the soul is a part of the supreme soul, and they engage in devotional service, then that is perfection.
如果还有人能觉悟到他们只是这个至尊灵魂的一部分，他应该从事奉献服务的话，这个是更完美。
So that means they can go to Vaikuntha, or they can go even to Krishna Loka.
这样的话。这意味着他们可以去到 Vaikuntha 或者 Krishna Loka.
So Yamaraj, he is one of these great devotees. He's a perfect devotee. He's a Mahajan.
Yamaraj 是一位非常伟大的奉献者，他是一位伟大的 Mahajan, 权威。
So the Yamaduras, they know that their master Yamaraj, he's a great devotee. So they know that Yamaraj's position is above the demigods.
这些亚玛都塔也知道亚玛拉吉的地位，他们知道亚玛拉吉是在半世人之上的。
So they're asking the Vishnu Duras, why They're asking the Vishnu Duras about where does the sinful man go when he's going to die? Ajimil hadn't died yet. He was still there in the body. But the Yamaduras, they were trying to take him out from the body. They couldn't get the soul out, so he wasn't dead yet. The soul was still in the body. Right, and so the Vishnu Duras and the Yama Duras, they are having an argument about should he be taken from the body or should be allowed to stay in the body. Yeah, who should get the soul of Ajamila? So that the servants of Yamaraj, they're talking to the Vishnu Duras, and they're describing them. Remember that the Yamaduras, they were really ugly and frightening looking people. But the Vishnu Duras are very different, that their eyes are like lotus petals. And they're dressed in yellow silk cloth. And they have garlands of lotus flowers. And they have beautiful helmets on their heads. And they have earrings, and they're very fresh and young looking. And they have four arms decorated with different symbols of Vishnu. And they're very effulgent, and their effulgence has removed all the darkness of that place. So Yamaduras are asking, so why are you bothering about us? Why are you interfering with what we're doing? And Prabhupada says, just like if you meet a foreigner, you meet some foreigner from a foreign land, and he will have different bodily features and different behavior. So you can understand something about him just from his features and his behavior.
圣帕帕德在这里提到，就像我们遇到一些外国人，我们就从他们的行为举止、外貌、身体的一些特征，就知道他们是跟我们不一样的。So
when the Yamadutas saw the Vishnu Dutas, they were really surprised.
当亚玛杜塔见到维什努杜塔的时候，他们非常的惊讶。
And they could understand these Vishnu Duras must be very special people. They must be in a very big position. Because just by their effulgence, they've taken away the darkness of this place. So the Yamaduras are surprised. Why are you interfering with what we're doing? We're working with a sinful person, taking him to hell. Why are you people worrying about this?
你们而且因此这些亚玛杜塔就感觉到很惊讶，你们为什么要来阻止我们履行我们的公务？我们在和一个有罪恶的人在打交道。
So you see, the Yamadutas had made this mistake. They were thinking Ajamila was very sinful. They didn't know that actually he had purified himself from all his sins by chanting the name of Narayan.
我们可以看到亚玛杜塔事实上犯了一些错误，他们并不知道阿加，他们只是认为阿加米勒有罪，但是他们并不知道阿加米勒通过唱诵圣名，他所有的罪恶都得到了净化。
Without being a devotee, you cannot understand the activities of a devotee.
除非你成为一个奉献者，否则你无法理解一个奉献者的所作所为。
So this verse is describing about the appearance of the people from Vaikuntha. It describes about their dress and how they appear.
在这节诗里面，我们也可以看到对瓦昆塔居民的描述。他们的举止，他们的特征，以及他们所穿着打扮。
And you can see they look very similar to Lord Vishnu.
而且我们看到他们和主威士努非常的像。
And because they've already got liberation, so they've got the same kind of bodily features, the four arms, like Lord.
因为他们也得到了，因为他们也属于解脱，所以他们和至尊主有一样的身体的特征，四肢、手臂等等。
But still, they have the mood of being servants. They don't think that now we're God. We're still servants. They have the mood of being the servants of the Lord.
但是虽然他们和至尊主有一样的身体特征，他们明白他们是至尊主的仆人。
So they're all self-realized souls, they're liberated souls, but they're all in the mood of being servants.
他们都是觉悟自我的，解脱了灵魂，但是他们也明白他们是仆人。
Now they do look like the Supreme Lord, but they're not.
他们确实跟至尊主很像，但是他们不是至尊主。
So this is what Vaikuntha Loka is like. That there's many inhabitants there, and they all look like Lord Narayan, but they're all servants. There's only one Supreme Lord.
这就是 Vaikuntha Loka 的这些情况，他们所有的这些人都有着至尊主的这些特征，但是他们都是至尊主的仆人。只有一位至尊主。
So by our Krishna consciousness movement, we will also develop this Vaikuntha consciousness.
通过 Krishna 知觉之中的学习，我们也逐渐的了解这些 Vaikuntha 的。我们也逐渐具有 Vaikuntha 的这些知觉。
Never identify with the material world.
而与物质世界是没有关系的。
So when the Vishnu Duras heard these words of the Yamaduras, then they smiled and they spoke, they replied to these questions, and they replied in the voices, their voices, which their voices were like thunder, like, you know, very heavy sound.
当威士努杜塔听到亚玛拉吉的这些话时，他们微笑着，然后以一种非常深沉的话语、深沉的声音说了下面的这些话。
So the Yamadutas could see that the Vishnu Dutas, that although they're trying to stop them from taking Ajamila, still they're very polite in their dealings.
Yamadutta 非常惊讶，就是。即便威士努都塔阻止了他们的这个行为，而且但是他们仍然都非常有礼貌。
And the Vishnu Duras, they're surprised that the Yamaduras don't know what is the real principles of religion.
而维什诺都塔也感觉到很惊讶，他们竟然这些亚玛都塔连最高的原则都不知道是什么。
So they're smiling at the Yamadurus and they're saying, what is this you're speaking? This is nonsense what you're speaking.
Yama 这个维什诺都塔微笑着，他们在想，你们在胡说些什么？
If you are really servants of Yamaraj, you should know that Ajameel is not a sinful person.
维什诺都塔笑着说，如果你们真的是 Yamaraj 的仆人，你们就应该知道阿迦米勒不是罪恶的人。
You have no right to take him to Yamaloka.
你们没有权利把他带到 Yamaloka 那里去。
So the Vishnudurus said to the Yamadurus, if you're really servants of Yamaraj, then you tell us the meaning of religious principles.
维什诺都塔接着说，如果你们真的是 Yamaraja 的仆人，那就请你告诉我们什么是真正的宗教原则。
And tell us also what are the symptoms of irreligion.
而且也请你告诉我们什么是非宗教的特征。
So this is a very good question to ask somebody.
这是一个非常好的问题，向别人问的时候。
And Prabhupada explains that if you're going to be somebody's servant, you have to know what is the teachings of the master.
Shrimpapada 在这里澄清到，如果你声称是某人的仆人的话，那你就得了解你主人的命令是什么。
So the servants of Yamaraj were carrying out, they said we're carrying out the orders of our master, Yamaraj.
Yamaraj 的仆人声称在执行 Yamaraj 的命令。
So the Vishnudurus are asking the Yamadurus, then tell us, what are the symptoms of religion and irreligion?
因此，维什诺都塔非常聪明地要求 Yamadutta, 请告诉我们什么是宗教原则和非宗教原则的特征。
Anybody who is a devotee, they'll know these principles.
任何一位奉献者都应该了解这些原则。
Because they know the teachings of the Supreme Lord.
因为他们知道至尊主的教导是什么。
Just in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, give up all the other varieties of religion and just take shelter of me.
就像至尊主在《薄伽梵歌》中说，放弃一切宗教，只是臣服于我。
So surrender to Krishna is...the actual principle of religion.
因此，臣服至尊人格守神是真正的宗教原则。
But if you've surrendered to the material nature instead of Krishna, then that's not pious. That's sinful. That's impious.
但是如果一个人不臣服 Krishna, 反而臣服物质自然的话，那是不虔诚的。
It doesn't matter what your position is in the material world, it's not pious to surrender to the material nature.
不管你在这个社会上的物质地位身份是如何，如果你只是向物质自然臣服的话，那不是虔诚的。
And if they don't surrender to Krishna, then they're sinful and they're lowest of men.
如果他不臣服于 Krishna 的话，他应该被认为是罪恶的，而且是最低的人。
If somebody is not surrendered to Krishna, then they don't know what are the real principles of religion.
如果他不臣服的话，他根本就无法理解真正的宗教原则是什么。
If they did know what are the principles of religion, they would have surrendered to Krishna.
如果他知道真正的宗教原则是什么的话，他会臣服 Krishna。
So it's very important for us as devotees, we have to know what is the mission of the Krishna consciousness movement.
对于奉献者来说，要知道 Krishna 知觉运动的使命是什么，非常的重要。
If we don't know what is the mission of Lord Krishna or Lord Chaitanya, then people will laugh at us.
如果我们不知道主 Krishna 的使命，主 Chaitanya 的使命，那么人们就会嘲笑我们。
Especially if we're going to try to present the teachings of Lord Krishna, we have to know.
尤其是那些想要向人们呈现 Krishna 教导的人，他必须知道这些。
So then the Vishnu Dutas also asked the Yama Dutas, what is the process of punishing other people?
Vishnu Dutta 接着又问，那么惩罚他人的程序和方法是什么呢？
And who should be punished?
谁应该受到惩罚？
If anybody who is doing fruitive material activities, should they all get punished? Or only some of them?
是那些所有从事功利性活动的人都应该受到惩罚，还是说只是他们其中的部分人？
So you may have the power to punish people, it doesn't mean you should punish everyone.
你或许有权利去，有力量去惩罚别人，但并不意味着你应该去惩罚每一个人。
The majority of souls are in the spiritual world. They're liberated souls.
有无数的生物，大部分的生物都在灵性世界，他们都是解脱了的灵魂。
So you cannot judge the liberated souls. You cannot do anything about them.
你无法去对这些解脱的灵魂去评判、判决他们。
And most of the forms of the living entities in the material world, they don't have a human body. They have a lower form of life. So they cannot get punished.
而在这个物质世界之中的大部分的生物，绝大部分的生物，他们都没有人类的这个躯体，他们不应该受到惩罚。
Right? You cannot punish animals or you cannot punish trees.
你不可能去惩罚动物，你也不能去惩罚树木。
But human being, he is a higher consciousness, he can be responsible, but you cannot punish all of them.
而人类，他们虽然应该承担责任，但是你也不应该惩罚所有的人。
Some people are doing very pious activities, you cannot punish them.
有一些人从事着非常虔诚的活动，你不能惩罚这些虔诚的人。
But if people do acts against the scripture, sinful activities, these people are punishable.
而如果一些人他反对这些经典的这些活动和做一些与经典相违背的这些活动，这些人应该受到惩罚。
So the Yamadutta, the Vishnu Dutas want to understand.How is somebody to be judged? What's the basic principle to judge who should be punished?
Vishnu Dutta 想了解惩罚的这个程序是什么，到底谁应该受到惩罚。
So then the Yamadutas reply, and they say that, well, whatever it says in the Vedas, that is real religious principle.
亚摩都塔回答道：“任何由《伟达经》里面所写成的，都是宗教原则。
And anything which is opposite of what it says in the scriptures, that is irreligion.
而与《伟达经》中所描述的相悖的、相反、相对立的，是非宗教。
And then the Yamadutas say that the Vedas are directly Lord Narayan, and they're self-born.”
亚摩多塔说，伟达经是直接由至尊主，是直接由至尊人格守神那儿样的自身的，直接就是至尊人格守神，他是自身的。
And the Yamadutta said, we heard all this from Yamaraj, he told us this.
而且他们说，我们从 Yamaraj 那里听到这些的，是 Yamaraj 告诉我们的。
So the Yamadutta said, they're answering correctly, they're notand speculating, they're not manufacturing, they're just repeating what they heard from their master.
Yamaraj 的仆人回答得非常正确，他们没有心智思辨，他们 他们是从他们的主人那里聆听的。
So this is the proper way that their master Yamaraj is an authority, and they repeat what they heard from him.
而且这也是非常正确的。他们从Yamaraj是权威，他们从权威那里聆听，然后重复他们。
Other people, they manufacture, they like to manufacture their own philosophy. That is not religion. So in the very beginning of Srimad Bhagavatam, Srila Vyasadeva spoke about what is real religion and what is not religion.
在圣典博迦瓦坛，圣维亚斯德瓦在开始的时候就讲述了什么是宗教，什么是非宗教。Right,
and some, and he says that what is irreligion that should be given up, that has to be rejected.
那些非宗教，我们应该放弃，应该拒绝。Real
religion is what is given by the Supreme Lord.
真正的宗教是由至尊主给予的。
And we should accept that, and we should give up all the other full ideas.
我们应该接受至尊主给予我们的，我们应该放弃其他所有的想法和概念。
Just like in the Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna was thinking that violence was not good. He was thinking that was irreligion, so he didn't want to fight.
就像在博迦梵歌的开始，阿尔朱那认为暴力是非宗教原则，因此他拒绝作战。
But Krishna encouraged him to fight.
但是 Krishna 鼓励他应该去作战。So
Arjuna, he followed the orders of Krishna, and because he followed the orders of Krishna, that was Dharma.
因此阿尔朱那遵循了 Krishna 的命令，由于他遵循 Krishna 的命令，那就是 Dharma 宗教。And
Arjuna is a follower of Dharma. And then also in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says that by all the Vedas, I am to be known.
在博迦梵歌中，主Krishna也说，我是通过所有的伟达经可以知道我。The
real purpose of the Vedas is to know Krishna.
伟达知识的目的是为了了解Krishna。And
anybody who knows Krishna, he is liberated.
而任何了解Krishna的人，他是解脱了的人。One
who actually knows Krishna, he will know that Krishna's birth and Krishna's activities are not material, they're transcendental.
任何了解Krishna的人，他知道Krishna的出身，他的活动都不是物质的，他们是超人。
And if we know this, then we become qualified to go back to Godhead.
如果我们能理解这一些的话，我们能有资格回归守神。
So real religion is what is given in the Vedas, and irreligion is what is not in the Vedas.
真正的宗教是伟达经所训练的，而非宗教不没有在伟达经中，就是相不被伟达经所支持的。
And we should understand that even Dharma is not something manufactured by Narayana.
我们也应该知道宗教原则实际上不是Narayana臆造出来的。
No, the principles of religion comes from the breathing of Narayana.
宗教原则是来自于Narayana的呼吸。
Narayana is eternal. He exists eternally, and he breathes eternally.
主 Narayana 是永恒存在的，他永恒的存在，也永恒的呼吸。
And the teachings of Narayana, the principles which he give, they also exist eternally.
因此，他给出的教导，这些，这也是永恒存在的。
So the words of the Veda, they come from the Supreme Lord.
伟达经的这些话语是来自于至尊主。
So the word the words coming and the words in the Vedas, that there are Vaishnava principle, because Vishnu is the origin of the Vedas.
维达经的这些话语是歪士纳瓦奉献者的原则，因为这个维达经它实际上就是至尊主。
The Vedas has nothing but the teachings of Vishnu.
维达经只是至尊主的教导。
One who follows the Vedic teachings, he's a Vaishnava.
任何追随维达原则教导的人，他是一位奉献者。
Vaishnava is not just a member of some people, it's not just somebody who makes up the philosophy.
Vaishnava 不是那些创造这些哲学的人。
A Vaishnava means somebody who actually knows the Vedas.
Vaishnava 意味着他理解韦达经。
And the message of the Vedas is given there in the Bhagavad Gita.
而韦达经的这些信息在《薄伽梵歌》中有给出。
So then the Yamadutas say, actually, the cause of all causes is Narayan.
Yamaduta 就说，一切的源头，万源之源，实际上是 Narayan.
He lives in the spiritual world, but he controls the material world.
他住在灵性世界，但是他控制着物质世界。
And he controls the material world through the three modes of nature.
他控制着物质世界通过三种属性。
So in this way, different people are in different varnas, like Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya.
因此就有不同的人，就住在不同的这个 varna 里面，比如说。Brahma, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra,
and they have different duties according to their positions in the different castes.
根据他们不同的职责，他们根据他们不同的所在的位置，他们履行着不同的职责。
So Narayan, he is the cause of this whole material world.
Narayan 呢是整个宇宙展示的原因。
He is the Supreme Lord, and he is.Almighty and all-powerful.
Narayana, 他是孔武有力，无所不能。
And he has all kinds of different energies.
他拥有各种各样的能量。
He can stay in his own abode, but at the same time, he can be supervising everything in the material world.
他居住在自己的居所，但是却毫不费力的，就是通过展示各种各样的能量。
And that's why we get different forms, different bodies, different activities.
而这些物质自然的这些能量就是造成了我们有各种各样不同的形体、躯体。
And because the Lord is perfect, everything works as if he were supervising it directly.
因为至尊主他是完美的，所以每一件事情在也是在他的直接的监督下。
But you've got a class of people who are atheists, and they're covered by the modes of nature. They cannot understand how there's a person behind this world.
但是那些无神论者，由于被物质自然属性所覆盖，他们不理解这一切的背后有至尊主的存在。
So these people are covered by the material energy. They cannot understand the nature of the Supreme Lord.
因为这些无神论者被自然属性所覆盖，他们看不到至尊主在背后。
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, "Abhajanante mam mudha manushim tanamashritam param bhavam ajananto mama bhuta maheshwaram."That I am never manifest to the foolish and unintelligent, for them I am covered by my eternal nature.
我从不向那些愚昧愚蠢的人揭示自己，对于他们，我用我的物质自然能量遮蔽我自己。
So the sun, the fire, the sky, everything is.The energy of the Supreme Lord.
太阳、天空、 空气、阳光，一切的这一切都是至尊主的能量。
And they witness the activities of all the living entities.
而且他们监视着这一切这物质世界的一切，物质世界的这些所有的生物体。
So some people, you know, like Christians, they don't believe in karma.
有一些人，比如说这些基督徒，他们并不相信业报。
And Prabhupada explains, he said one time he had a discussion with a Christian professor, and the Christian professor argued that although people are punished because of their deeds, he said, who are the witnesses? He said, there's no witnesses to their activities.
有一次，这个圣帕帕德和一位博学的这个宗教基督教的教授进行讨论，这些教授他们反驳道，他们即便看到有一些人绳之以法，但是他们说这些见证者到底在什么地方，谁在监察着我们这些生物。
So the Yamaduras are giving the answer to this person. They're mentioning names all the people, all the different things which are witnesses to our actions.
所以亚玛都塔在这里就描述了到底谁是所有这些生物体的监察者和见证者。
A materialistic person thinks nobody is seeing his sinful activities.
这些物质主义者往往就认为没有人能看得到他所做的罪恶活动。
But there are many witnesses. There's the sun.
但事实上，
There's the sun, there's the fire, there's the sky, the air, the moon.
事实上有很多的见证者，包括太阳、火、天空、空气、月亮。
Demigods.
半神人。
Then the day and the night, water.
白天夜晚水。
Land.
土地。
And the super soul himself.It sits in everybody's heart. He witnesses everything.
而且还有超灵本人，他在每一个生物体的心中，他见证的所有的一切。
So there are many witnesses seeing everything we do.
因此有很多的见证者见证着我们所做的所有的一切。
And that's why some people they go up to higher planets, and some go down to lower planets.
这就是为什么有一些人他能够去到高等的星球，有一些人会堕落到低等的星球里面去。
It's all arranged perfectly under the management of the Supreme Lord.
一切都在至尊主的管理之下，非常完美的安排着。
So these witnesses are mentioned also in the Vedas. It's not something.
所有这些见证者都在伟达经中也提及过。
All right, so we will stop here.
好，我们今天讲到这里。
We'll ask if there's any questions.
Okay, yes. First question from Chandra Vinasi Rani, David Dasi. Hare Krishna, 感恩孤儿的仁慈，深深顶拜孤儿甜美的莲花族，顶拜翻译。今天请教孤儿两个问题。一，我们现在每周在铺子上联谊的人很少。感觉没有发挥出买铺子专门用于做服务的最大用途，我们想更多的人每周联谊，请教孤儿这种情况下是不是没有每天在铺子上做 RT 做好高质量的 Prasadam 所导致的。目前我每周在家里做 RT 出现这个问题，是不是我没有高质量的 Prasadam 导致的？萨提玛吉，这个铺子是啥意思？我现在每周在铺子上联谊，
就是他那里有一个，瑜伽馆吧，你就说瑜伽馆，咕噜知道。
OK， this question from Chandra Vinasi Rani Mataji. She said every week, in our yoga center, we don't have many people to associate.I think this yoga center didn't use it to 感觉没有发挥它的最大用途。 So, not so many people come. I see, did I not make a higher? Does it because of I didn't make the higher quality of the prasadam?
Well, you have to be patient. It takes time.
你应该耐心，这个是需要花一点时间的。
Don't think immediately you'll get a lot of people. It's going to take time.
不要想着一开始就会有很多的人来，这需要花费一点时间。
But if you're patient and if you're steady and you keep the program going, gradually people will come.
如果你很有耐心，持续地做这个活动的话，人们会来的。
So of course, prasadam should be nice. Sometimes it will be better, sometimes it won't be so much. Do your best.
Prasadam 做得很好，那当然很好。但是有时候好，有时候很，有时候也会出现一点不好。但是呢，你尽可能的，尽你最大的努力去做就行。
When Prabhupada began his program, he would just have one apple, and he would cut the apple up in pieces, and he'd give everyone a piece of apple.
在圣帕帕德最开始做节目、做活动的时候，他只是用一个苹果，然后用他整个活动的这个 prasadam 就是一个苹果，然后他把这个苹果切成一小片一小片，分给所有的人。
So it's not only prasadam. You don't want to just depend on prasadam alone. For the people have to be interested. They have to really want to understand Krishna consciousness.
你不可能只是依靠普沙的一个这个力量这个呈现。你不可能完全只是依靠普沙的。人们来这儿是因为他们有兴趣，人们要有兴趣，他们才会来。
So the idea is, you get people together, you know, and you have a little program.You do some chanting, you hear a little philosophy, and you take whatever simple prasadam you can arrange.
所以理想的情况是你把人们聚集在一起，然后给他们一点唱诵，有一点点哲学，然后再有一些 prasadam.
Now don't expect immediately you're going to get a lot of people.
不要期望在马上你就会有很多的人就来了。
But if you're steady, if you're and you keep the program going, gradually you'll make more friends and more people will come.
如果你很稳定，一直在做这个服务，做你的活动的话，逐渐的，你会有越来越多的朋友。
You have to remember also at this particular time, because of the pandemic, because of the disease which is going around.People are not so much inclined to come for programs.
你也应该理解，在这个病毒流行的这个病毒的这个期间，人们并不是一定有这个意向想要来参加你的这个活动。
So don't expect to get a lot of people just now. It's going to take a while before this thing gets over.
不要太期望于在当下这个阶段有特别多的人来参加，我们要再看等这个事情完全结束之后，就是这个病毒完全结束之后是什么样的一个情况。
Okay.
Second question she asked, 在阿卡达西全界第二天喝水就是破戒了吗？ Yes, Sati Mataji.
Krishna. Yeah. 他说的不是菩萨的，是萨达那。
萨德纳目前没有在家中，他最后一句话说，出现这种问题是不是我没有高质量的哦？
萨德纳，对，
萨德纳 ，OK, good day. First question, finally she said, I translated something wrong. Finally she asked, is this problem because of the I'm not doing the.Higher quality of sadhana.
Well, I don't know. I don't know what sadhana you're doing. You definitely want to try to do good sadhana. Sadhana is important for your own spiritual life.
She said every day she do the manga art at home.
Okay, that's good.
做早art是很好的。And then she didn't mention the others.
Okay. Anyway, you know, be patient. Gradually, you keep the program going. You keep your, you can do your chanting at home. That's okay. You do your arti at home, no problem.
保持你的耐心，你在家里，在家里保做这个arti很是好的。Second, she asked, when during the Akadashi, I fall fast, and the second day, I just drink. Is that drink means I break the Akadashi?
Yes, you do full fast on Akadashi, you do nirjal on Akadashi, so you can break fast by drinking the next day.
是的。你如果在阿克达西全戒，在第二天只是喝水，就是属于，就是破戒。
But you don't need to do all that. You know, you don't need to do all that in this Kali Yuga. You don't have to do all these austerities. You may frighten people away by doing all this kind of austerities.
你没有必要在这个卡利年代这样做。如果你这样做的话，在这个卡利年代，你或许会把别人给吓跑。
When Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati was doing all this, Bhaktivinoda Thakur told him, he said, you don't need to do all this. He said, then you should take prasadam on Akadasi.
Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur 是这么做的，但是呢 Bhaktivinoda Thakur 也就是他父亲告诉他，你没有必要这么做，你可以吃 prasadam。
The main point is to remember, increase your remembrance of Krishna by doing more chanting.
而重要的要点是你应该增加增加更多的意念 Krishna, 通过唱诵的形式意念 Krishna.
Right. Okay.
Okay. Next question from Mathura Nina Mataji. Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru 和所有的奉献者，请问 Guru, 怎样做才是叫真正的臣服 Krishna 呢？How we can do is means we fully surrendered unto Krishna.
Well, you should always think I need to surrender more. You should never think I fully surrendered. You should think I need to surrender more.
你永远不要想着我已经完全臣服了，而你想的是我应该更多的臣服。这个就是。
Yes.So we want to go on surrendering. Surrendering is a continuous process. We want to surrender more and more.
Surrender 就是臣服，它是一个逐渐的过程。因此，我们应该想的是逐步、逐步的，更多、更多的想，更多、更多的臣服 Krishna.
We don't ever want to think, "Oh, I fully surrendered." No, we want to surrender more.
我们不想，我们不会想着我们已经完全臣服了。我们想的是，我更多的去臣服 Krishna。目前没有看到了。
Okay, no more questions. Well, there are no more questions. I've got some. One devotee wrote some questions to me. Maybe we
okay.
can answer them here.
Okay.
I'll read them to you. This is from Mataji, Yashoda Krishna Mataji.So her first question is, she She said that she was in a lot of pain over the last couple of days. And a husband said, at times like that, it's okay if I can't chant 16 rounds.
这个问题是来自于亚修达，亚修达Krishna Mataji，他在过去的几天感觉到非常的痛苦，他的丈夫就说，是他的丈夫感觉到非常的痛苦，他的丈夫就说，如果是在我临死之前这样的话，我觉得还可以，如果我能唱诵16圈的话。
And her husband believes that Krishna will understand.
而且她的丈夫说， 他认为 Krishna, Krishna 会理解的。
And you can always, and she, he told her that you can always make it up, make the rounds up another time.
Sorry, Gurudev, make the rounds
up. Yeah, you can catch up. Like if you can't chant today, then chant next week, or you chant tomorrow, or you chant more rounds tomorrow.
Okay. This is her husband said.
Yeah.
她丈夫说，就 Krishna 会理解的。如果我今天完成不了的话，我明天去完成，或者下一周完成。嗯嗯嗯。
You have to chant extra rounds to make up for the rounds you didn't chant. Right? If you only chant 10 rounds today, then tomorrow you should chant 16 rounds plus another 6 rounds.
Yes. 就是说，如果今天只唱诵了十圈，本来应该完成16圈的话，那么明天的话，你应该是16圈再加上昨天的这个十圈，把昨天的这个给补回来。So
the Mataji thought, she said that, well, she just got initiation recently, and she would like to, she said it would be painful for her not to strictly follow the vow.
因为这个Mataji刚刚启迪，她感觉到没有很严格的遵循这个誓言，感觉到很痛，有点难受。So
she said she's, although she was not in a good, so good, she was in a lot of pain, she chanted all the rounds anyway.
所以她说，即便她没有很大的痛苦，但是她每一天都完成所有的圈数。
So she's asking me, is it okay to miss sometimes the rounds or reduce the number of rounds when you're sick?
Oh, 她的问题是，当她生病的时候，能否有一些圈数是可以减少的？就是说，在第二天再补回来，能不能这样的情况出现？
Well, everything depends on the time and the place and the circumstances.
孤儿的回答是：一切的情况取决于时间、地点和特定的情况。You
know, sometimes you know you may be very sick, you may not be able to chant, you may not be able to do anything.
有些时候你或许生病的很严重，你根本就无法唱诵。So
very hard to do your rounds.
因此你很难完成你的圈数。
But we shouldn't be very happy about that kind of situation.
但是我们不应该为此种情况下而感觉到快乐。
We want to try to avoid that kind of situation.
我们应该避免这样的情况再次出现。
And we know that the most important instruction of all the instructions we get from the spiritual teacher, the most important one is to chant 16 rounds.
而我们知道，我们从我们的灵性导师那里得到的最重所有的训示之中最重要的训示就是念诵16圈。
And by chanting 16 rounds, then we keep ourselves connected to Krishna.
通过念诵16圈，我们才能够和 Krishna 保持连接。
The problem is if we stop chanting 16 rounds, then we'll think other days it's all right to do it.
这个问题就在于，如果我们在当天不念诵完16圈的话，我们就会认为 其他的这个情况也是可以不念诵十六圈的，就是一旦开始不遵守这个，就后面又会有情况发生。
So it should have it has to be some really serious situation. You have to be really sick that you really can't chant, and then it's okay not to miss your japa.
嗯，因此这个特定的情况是，除非你病到是真的很难病的，你真的无法念诵的，你可以在那个时候减少你的japa。
Sometimes you may have to listen to Prabhupada chanting and count the mantras on your beads.
在那样的情况下，你也可以去聆听圣帕帕帕德的念诵，然后你可以在手上继续拨动念珠。
And we have to try to chant in the mind.
那个时候我们得尝试着用心意念诵。
But that's not really what we want to do.
但那并不是我们真正想要去做的事情。
But it may be because of our health, we may have to do that.
但是可能的话，因为我们的身体情况导致我们不得不那样去做的时候，我们那样做。
Okay.
Okay.
And now here's another question.
Yes.
It's about Lord Rama and Mother Sita.
Yes.
So she says that every year she finds herself a bit upset by what happened to Mother Sita and all the suffering she had to go through.
这个问题是关于西塔主席Rama 和西塔母亲的。就是每一年他都感觉到有一点点悲伤，他就感觉到这个西塔母亲所遭受的这个情况。
So she said, although Lord Rama is playing the role of the perfect king, but she said, I don't feel so much love for him as Krishna.
虽然主 Rama 扮演了一个完美的国王的这个角色，但是我并没有在他身上感觉到我并没有对他有很多的这个爱，即便他是 Krishna。
Because Lord Rama let Mother Sita suffer so much.
因为主 Rama 让 Sita 遭受了那么多的痛苦。
So I had mentioned that I said, well, it's all right that you can choose which particular deity, which form of the Lord you want to worship.
姑的回答是，这个没关系，你可以根据你的愿望去选择你想崇拜的这个神像。
So she said, I know we don't worship Lord Buddha or Lord Parashuram the same way as we would worship Krishna.
这个妈的姐回答是，我们也知道我们并不崇拜主佛陀和 Parashurama, 我们崇拜的是 Krishna.
So she said, I think it's okay to love Krishna more than Rama.
这个 Mother 姐说，我觉得我是否爱这个 Krishna 要多于爱 Rama, 我应该爱 Krishna 多于爱 Rama.
But she said, I feel bad about it. And I was wondering if I could develop, how could I develop my love for Lord Rama?
但是这个妈的姐的想法是，我如何来发展，就是提升我对 Rama 的这个爱。
Well, is it all right for me to just be respectful to Lord Rama and continue to be more attracted to Krishna and Lord Chaitanya and Lord Nrisingadev?
就是说我是否应该发展出对 Rama 的爱，还是说我继续保持我现在的这个状况，只是尊敬主 Rama?发展出我对 Krishna 和主 Chaitanya 的爱就行了。
So we have to understand that maybe we have not fully appreciated everything about the pastimes between Lord Rama and Mother Sita.
我们得了解到，布鲁的回答是，我们得了解到，我们或许并没有完全的欣赏到主 Rama 和 Sita 的这个逍遥时光的过程。
And should we have to understand that Lord Ram, when Mother Sita had to go to Valmiki's ashram, when she was away from Lord Rama was also suffering. He was also in separation from his consort, Mother Sita. It was painful for him. It wasn't just painful for Sita.
当西塔母亲去到瓦米克的阿什朗的时候，对西塔母亲是一种遭受，但是我们也得理解到，这对Rama是一种遭受，也是一种痛苦。Rama也承受了很大的苦。But
we have to understand that by that separation, that when they're together again, when they come together, they will feel more ecstatic, they will feel more pleasure.
我们也得理解到，通过他们之间的这种分离，当他们再一次相聚的时候，他们会有更多的这种狂喜，更多的这种爱。
And that separation increases their love for each other.
这种分离增加了他们之间的相互之间的爱。
Remember, Lord Rama didn't go to any other woman. He made a vow, only one wife.
我们也看到Rama他并没有走向任何一个女性那里，他发誓只对Sita，只娶一个女人。And
there, we should understand that Sita and Rama are always together in the spiritual world.
我们还得了解到，Sita和Rama，主Rama和Sita，他在灵性世界是永远在一起的。So
you shouldn't worry so much about, we should understand properly this separation between Sita and Rama.
因此要恰当地理解Sita和Rama之间的这个逍遥时光，他们的分离。
This is their pastime potency, their pastime, they're presenting this Leela. It's all full of rasa. The rasa of love and separation.
这是他们呈现这个逍遥时光的力量，呈现的这个逍遥时光全部都是rasa关系爱。
And we see the highest rasa is Madhurya ras, and in Ramayana there's only Parakya ras, which is the ras between husband and wife. There's no Parakya ras is relationship between man and woman without marriage, but in Ramayana it's only Swakiya Ras. They're married. The husband Rama and Sita are married, so they can associate together. But with Krishna, you've got Parakiya Ras, relationship without marriage. But with Ramayana, you don't have this Parakiya Ras. You just have Swakiya Ras.
在Ramayana中，这个是 Swakiya Rasa， 就是妻子和丈夫之间的结了婚的这种关系的存在。但是在主 Krishna 那里是没有结婚的这种 Rasa， 这个 Guru Dev 叫什么名字
？Parakiya
Parakiya 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 Rasa。
Yeah, not married. Krishna with the gopis is Parakiya Rasa。 Without marriage.
Krishna 和Gopi和木流姑娘们之间是 Parakya Rasa, 没有结婚的这种关系的存在。
So, I think you need to be more, you need to hear more Ramkatha and try to appreciate more the glories of Lord Ramachandra, and that will help you a lot.
我觉得你应该更多的聆听 Ramayana 的这个逍遥时光，这个能够帮助你了解更多。
There were some wonderful katas on the internet recently, some different devotees, Indian people. One was a man. He was the president of the temple in Chicago, and he was giving a class on the qualities of Lord Rama, and it was very wonderful to hear all the qualities of Lord Rama.
最近在这个网上有很多的关于主 Rama 的这个逍遥时光，关于他的话题的这个讨论，在芝加哥的这个有一个印度人，他们讲述的非常好，关于主 Rama 的这些品质。
Now generally we find that the pastimes of Lord Rama are more appreciated by people than the pastimes of Krishna, because Krishna has a lot of this parakya rasa, relationship with the gopis, the young girls. But Lord Rama is only with one wife, but Krishna has many, many women.
但是通常情况下，人们更多的去欣赏主 Rama 的这个逍遥时光，因为主 Rama 只有一个妻子，而 Krishna 他有很多很多的妻子。
So we find some often people, they're not much so much in favor of pastimes of Lord Krishna,But they're much more inclined to hear the pastimes of Lord Rama. They find the pastimes of Lord Rama much more acceptable.
We see that many people are very much like Lord Rama's pastime time, and Krishna's pastime time is not so much compared to Rama, not so much like.
But everybody has their own particular taste.
但是每一个人他都有他自己独特的品味。
Some people's taste is to hear about Krishna's pastimes, and some people's taste is to hear about Lord Ram.
有一些人他喜欢听主 Krishna 的逍遥时光，有一些人喜欢听主 Rama 的逍遥时光。
So Lord Rama is also included there in Srimad Bhagavatam. Sukadeva Goswami also spoke briefly about Lord Rama.
主 Rama 的逍遥时光在圣典波迦瓦坛中也有描述， Sukadeva Goswami 对他进行了简短的描述。
Right, you can read in the ninth canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, Lord Rama's pastimes are described in two chapters.
你可以在圣典波迦瓦坛第九篇描述，圣 Sukadeva Goswami 用两章的时间描述了这个他的逍遥时光。
Are there any other questions here?
Yes, this question from Hadvamsa Prabhu. Guru, 是不是我们念诵神的任何名字时，神或神的使者都与我们同在，就如念诵 Narayana 一样？ Hadvamsa ask, whether when we chanting the Lord, any name of the Lord and the Lord Dutta, they will...be with us at that time is like the when we chant the Narayana.
Yes. Yes.
是的
The messengers.
是的
The messengers of the Lord will also be there.
神的使者也会与我也会在内
Garuda will come.
Garuda 会来
We read about Dhruva Maharaj going back to Godhead. The Vishnu Duras came to get him, to take him back.
我们听到 Dhruva Maharaj 回归守神的时候 ，Vishnu Dutta 也来了。
So the Duras will come, the servants of the Lord will also come along with the Lord. But we have to chant purely. We have to chant without offense.
是的，他们都会来，但是呢，我们要纯粹的唱诵，没有冒犯的唱诵。
Don't think it's so easy thing to chant the holy name without offense.
不要认为没有冒犯的唱诵这是一件容易的事情。
We have to practice. Antimyo chanted a lot.
我们得好好的练习。阿姐米勒他都唱诵了很多
He chanted his son's name many, many times.
他唱诵他儿子的名字非常非常多的次数。
And remember, Ajameya had some punya because he was born a brahmana, and he'd been worshipping the Shila as a young man.
我们还知道阿姜弥勒他是出生在一个婆罗门的家庭。当他年轻的时候，他还崇拜了这个希腊。
Yes.
Next question from Radha Priya Mataji. 顶拜孤儿的莲花组感恩翻译和主持，仅仅通过完全臣服和服务孤儿的训示，就会让我们越来越臣服 Krishna 吗？ Obeisance to Guru's Lord's feet. Fully surrender unto the Guru's instruction, is that can let us more and more surrender to Krishna?
Well, yes. If you have instructions from the Guru.
是的，如果你有从 Guru 那得到的训示的话。
Guru means Srila Prabhupada, the founder Acharya, his instructions.
Guru 意味着我们的创办灵性导师圣帕帕德他的训示。
So everything should be in accord with his mood and mission.
因此一切都应该在他的使命和他的心态之中。
And everybody else, all of the other devotees, they are serving the original founder Acharya.
而其他的所有的人都是在服务我们的这个founder Acharya.
And they're trying to, they want to connect us all to Prabhupada, to Prabhupada's mission.
他们希望把我们和帕帕德的使命连接起来。
So yes, we have to faithfully follow the orders, the instructions.
因此，我们是的，我们应该完全的遵循这个使命，遵循他们的训示。
Then you can get good results. You're sure. Then you can be sure of good results.
确保我们得到很好的结果。
Okay.
Yes.Next question from Hani Mamsa. Oh, Govinda Nandini. Mataji, 顶拜 Guru Dev, 想问一下，一旦我没有早起念诵完，白天就很难完成圈数，然后就会很焦虑。在家服务孩子和丈夫时，有时会把这些焦虑带给他们，经常会期待丈夫帮助做服务，让我完成圈数。如果不是我期待的那样，就更加焦虑，导致恶性循环。每天的灵性活动很少，我应该怎么办？Govinda Nandini ask, when I not get up early and finish my rounds in the daytime, it's hard for me to finish my rounds, and I feel some anxiety and so I have a lot of service. When the husband not help me to do this service, I feel more anxiety.And I will give this my anxiety to my husband and my child. So it's a very bad circle. Every day I didn't do many spiritual activities. So how should I do?
Well, first thing you need to do is get up early.
第一件你要做的事情就是早起。
You're going to get up early. Probably you need to sleep early.
如果你要早起的话，你就得早睡。
But you need to get up early and get some rounds done in the morning before your child wakes up.
如果你不早起的话，你就会在你小孩子起来之前，你就会还有一些圈数没练完。
You have a lot of time in the day. You have to use your time carefully.
白天你有很多的时间，你应该小心的利用这些时间。
Your husband goes to work at 7 in the morning. He comes home 10 o'clock at night. He's working all day and most of the night. So you're alone a lot. You have a lot of time. You have to use your time carefully.
你的丈夫七点钟出去，晚上十点钟回来。白天你一个人在家，实际上你的时间是很多的，你应该小心的利用这些时，仔细的利用这些时间。
Of course, when you have a child, I know it's difficult. Child's going to take your time and attention.
当然我知道你有小孩之后，是很有点困难的。你的小孩需要你的注意力。
So you have to be careful. Get your child to take rest. And when the child takes rest, then you can chant.
所以你得很小心的利用，仔细的利用你的时间。当你的小孩休息的时候，你就可以念诵了。
After some time, your child will go to nursery or go to school, then you have more time.
再过几年之后，你的小孩就可以去上学了。你小孩一上学，你就又可以念诵了。
So you have to just be, try to be cautious, try to be careful to not waste your time.
你只需要更加注意你的时间就好了，不要浪费你的时间。
Don't expect your husband to be helping you all the time at home. He's working all day.
不要期待着你的丈夫去帮助你，他一白天都在工作。
You're at home. Your job is to take care of the home. He's out working to maintain the home.
他的工作是在外边维系这个家，你的家是在这个家里面维系这个家。
So keep the home clean and tidy, and keep yourself looking attractive.
让你的家保持干净和整洁，让你的家变得有吸引力。
And you should look nice. You should look attractive.
而且你也应该看起来非常有吸引力，看起来很好看。
You should always be attractive for your husband.
对于你的丈夫来说，你应该总是保持你的吸引力。
Okay.Any other question?
Not yet. 没有了。
Okay, so I have one more question here.
Okay.
We always hear about devotees say we should pray to Krishna, pray to Lord Nrisimhadev for protection and blessings.
我们总是向主祈祷，能够给予我们的一些保护、一些庇护和祝福。
So devotees say, I don't feel comfortable asking for help.
但是有奉献者询问，就有奉献者说，我。当我向主寻求这些帮助的时候，我感到并不是很舒服。
I don't know when's a good time to ask.
我并不知道该在什么时候去寻求这些帮助。
And I don't think japa is meant for asking for help.
我也不认为这个 japa 这个念诵就是在寻求帮助。
So I'm trying to improve my japa.But sometimes the mind wanders.
我很想提升我的这个加帕，我的念诵，但是我的心意却不那么作为。
And I think about my hardships and about the problems I have.
当我想到我的这个问题的时候。
But I feel bad to ask Krishna for anything.
当我向 Krishna 寻求任何的帮助的时候，我感觉到不好。
But I feel I need to ask somebody for help. So who's the best? Krishna is the best.
但是如果我需要向人寻求帮助的话 ，Krishna 又是最好的。
But then I think, well, Krishna knows everything. I shouldn't have to tell him. I should just leave it all to him.
但是我又知道 Krishna 知道一切，我们应该让 Krishna 独处就好了。Krishna 他应该知道一切的。
I should just be happy with whatever happens to me.
我应该对于我发生的一切保持快乐就好。
I should just go and see the deity and be happy to see the deity.
我应该只是去快乐的去见神像。
And Krishna must get tired of hearing people asking him for so many things. So I don't want to be like everybody else who's always asking for something.
Krishna 一定对于那些经常向他们寻求帮助的人感觉到疲惫了。我不想像其他人一样那么去麻烦。
But she wants to know, is it okay to pray for things sometimes?
她想知这个奉献者询问的是，我到底在有一些时候我寻求帮向 Krishna 寻求帮助是不是好的呢？
And when and how should I pray?
那么何时以及如何祈祷是好的呢？
Well, usually the Christians, they will pray when before they take bed, go to sleep at night.
这些基督徒他们是在睡觉之前晚上的时候祈祷。
So should we do it when we go to see the deities? I should pray to the deities then? Or
我是不是应该去见神像的时候就向神像祈祷呢？
Or is it just sometimes we can pray to the deity and ask for something?
还是说有一些时候我可以向神像去祈祷？
Well, yes, actually it's going to be different for different people. Some people, they won't ask Krishna for anything.
This is your
my answer.
Reply,
yes.
Yeah. Okay. Guru 回答是的，对于不同的人，他们对于 Krishna 是不一样的。有一些人他向 Krishna 祈求，有一些人不向 Krishna 祈求。
Right. Some people they just depend on, they just surrender to Krishna. That Krishna, whatever you want, I accept.
有一些人他只是向 Krishna 臣服。他说 ，Krishna， 无论你给我安排什么，我都接受。
But not everybody's on that level that they can be so surrendered.
但并不是每一个人都是那么在那一个层面上的。
So we're going to pray to Krishna or pray to the Lord, pray to the deities for something. And then you can do it anytime.
在这种我们不是在那个层面的话，我们就可以向神像，向主去祈祷，任何时候都可以。
Yeah, it can be done any time of the, when it can be done in front of the deities, or it may be done first thing in the morning, or it may be done last thing at night.
我们可以去见神像的时候就向主祈祷，我们可以在早上起来的时候，或者说在晚上的时候也可以。
There are no rules about what time you can approach the Lord.
对于我们向主，我们去接近主，没有限制。
But the point is, you don't want to be coming all the time to the Lord with a big list. You know, it's not like.You know, Christian church, you have a shopping list and give me this, I need that, and we need this and that, and so many things and so many problems, you know. It shouldn't be like that. We should be a little sparing about going to Krishna. You don't want to bring everything to Krishna and ask him help in all situations.
要点是我们不是像这个去购物的那种，有一个清单哦，我要向 Krishna 要一二三四五等等，有这么一个清单，把所有的这一切都呈现在 Krishna 的面前。我们不是这样。
Yeah, but when we have a serious problem, then you know some real problem, very bad problem, then we can go to Krishna for help. Then okay.
当我们确实有一些问题，很严重的这种问题的时候，我们向 Krishna。
Just like just now, it's a you know very serious situation. We're very worried about Pankajangari Prabhu and his health situation. So we're all praying and we're asking the Lord, you know, kindly, if you can, please kindly keep him with us.
就像在现在这个时候，对于 Pankajangari Prabhu。是非常处境不是特别的好，我们都可以向主祈祷，请如果你愿意的话，请让他和我们在一起。
So this is not against the principles of pure devotion. When somebody's life is in danger, then it's not against the principles of pure devotion to pray to Krishna to save us.
这个并不是和纯粹的奉献服务相违背的，去 against the pure devotional service.
Yes, it is still, if we pray to Krishna, it's still pure devotion.
Okay, 如果我们向主 Krishna 祈祷的话，这仍是纯粹的奉献服务。
But we don't pray every day of the year, we don't pray to Krishna that save this person, save that person, save, you know, we don't, it has to be some very special situation.
一定是在某一些特别的这种情况下，我们这样的祈祷才行。不是说每一天我们都向 Krishna 祈祷，请救这个人，请救那个人，请救那个人。
So be careful, don't come to Krishna every day, every moment, for everything.
一定我们应该很小心，不是每一天，不是为每一件事情。
But when there's something serious, a big problem, then we come to Krishna.
当有一些特别的这个情况，特别的情况下时，我们向 Krishna 祈祷。
Okay, so we can stop here today.
Yes, Nila Kishore Mataji said, Hare Krishna, this afternoon, it said Pankajangar Prabhu can maybe some good news.
Oh, very good. So we'll keep praying. We'll keep praying for Pankajangari Prabhu.
我们继续为 Pankajangari Prabhu 祈祷。Okay. Sachi Mataji, 我们剩下的问题下一个星期问好吗？还有两个问题。
Okay, 下一个星期可以啊。或者星期二也可以。
星期二也可以。Okay.
好的，可以。
Okay, woman Ganshiya Subhuri Rai, Ki woman Jantai Dufani, Ganshiya Sati Jujur, Ganshiya Soyada Function Engine, Ling Ting Tiwan, Juhu Niman, Changsong Kwaila, Wanshi Rui, Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki,
Jai,
Gorbhaktivrinda Ki,
Jai,
Hare Krishna,
Hare.